John Harnum here. Someone requested that I do a little video on valves. Specifically, someone I think had their valve completely taken apart and was having trouble getting it back together. So let me just show you what I need to do. My third valve was sticking, so I took it out and I'm going to take it apart. Used to be that you can see there's a spring here. Used to be that these were valves had springs on the bottom. They changed that around. The valve was invented around 1815, the piston valve, or maybe it was the rotary valve. I'm not sure. I think the piston valve, 1815. Anyway, you can look that up easily. So there's a spring that allows you to push the valve up and down. And what I'm doing, I'm just going to take it apart and tell you the parts as I do it. So this is the valve button on the top. And you know, this might be pretty tight on your horn. It might be difficult to take off. Don't take pliers or anything to it. If you're having trouble with any of these, just take it to your repair guy, and he can do it without damaging it. So there's that. This is the valve cap that screws onto the instrument. Now, here is a little piece of felt. You might have rubber on yours. This is something I did not know about a number of years ago, and I have here a replacement felt. Now, when I first learned about this, the felt that I had on my horn was compressed probably to half this size or more. This is a brand new one. I don't actually need them. You can see that the thickness is about the same. This is turning a little bit green, but it still has some pretty good cushion to it. If your valves start to be clacky sounding, then you probably need some new padding here. I'd recommend felt. You can probably find this on most online instrument stores, or your instrument repairman will have them. So this continues to come apart. I don't even know what this part's called, but it helps to hold the spring down. I remember a number of years ago, I was having some trouble with my valves. They seemed to be not as fast as I'd like them. I ended up stretching this spring out a little bit. I don't know if that was a wise thing to do. It's since been replaced altogether with a brand new one. So anyways, here's the valve pretty much all the way taken apart. I'm not going to continue taking it apart. I don't want to damage it. Valves are pretty easy to damage, so if you're working on your valves, just be very careful with them. You know, sharp objects and scratches are bad. So anyway, the spring goes back in here. This part, whatever you call it, gets screwed back on. Now if my felts needed to be replaced at this point, you know, I would replace them, but they don't, they look good, so I'm just going to leave that there. The valve cap then goes on the top like this, and then the valve button on the top of that. I usually put it down fairly snug so that there's no noise or anything, and there you have it. You can see if you take your valve off, I actually cleaned the heck out of this because it was sticking. You can see it's my third valve. If you're not sure what number it is when you put it back in the horn, you can usually see, well, let's see, so there you go, there's number three right there. It's usually stamped somewhere on this part of the valve. Usually that number goes towards you, towards the mouthpiece, when you put it back in. You don't want to put it in and twist to find it, you know, to lock it in. That may cause scoring around the valve this way, and that's going to not allow the oil to flow and may cause sticking problems later. So if you can, when you put it back in, keep the three or the number, whatever number it is, aligned towards the mouthpiece and put it back in. Another thing that I learned, there's a great video on oiling and maintaining your valves at the Monette shop. Is literally just soaking and putting this over a garbage can and soaking it with valve oil before you put it back in. What that does is it cleans all of the debris off and it goes into the trash and it leaves it nicely oiled. They recommend doing that once before you play and once after you play, before you put the horn away. The reason for that is that spit has minerals in it and it will build up on the valve. This valve looks okay. I don't always put valve oil on it when I put the horn away. So you can see a little bit of that buildup here. That can be removed. It takes a chemical bath to do it, which can be expensive. So you can avoid that by just, you know, basically oiling the crap out of it before you put it back in the horn. And don't oil it while it's in the horn, because if you do that, what's happening is all of the gunk, even metal, you know, small bits of whatever is in there, food, who knows, If you oil it while it's in the horn, that's just going to wash into the horn, so you don't want that. So take, just take it over a garbage can and, drench it with oil and then put it in and you're good to go. So there it is. That's a quick little video on valve maintenance. I hope that helped you out. Take it easy.